एनवायरमेंट एंड क्लाइमेट सेल द्वारा आयोजित और एक वेबिनार आमार अहोमर गौरव तथा विशिष्ट वाइल्ड लाइफ एक्सपर्ट डॉक्टर पूर्णिमा देवी बर्मन उपस्थित आछे। तेखेत आदि प्रबल व्यक्ति हिसाब से आमार ए वेबिनार उपस्थित हुए तेखेतक आमी महाविद्यालय तरफर परा आदरणीय जानाइछो। मैडम वेलकम टू दिस वेबिनार। আমি অত্যন্ত সুখী আর কৃতজ্ঞ যে ডক্টর পূর্ণিমা দেবী বর্মন তেওঁর বহুত ব্যস্ততার মাজত ধুবুরী ভোলানাথ মহাবিদ্যালয়ক সময় দিব পাৰিছে আর আমি তার বাবে তেখেতক আমার মাজত পাই আমি গৌরবান্বিত অনুভব করেছি। আজি এইখন ওয়েবিনারত ভোলানাথ মহাবিদ্যালয়ের শিক্ষক শিক্ষয়িত্রী ছাত্র ছাত্রীর বাইরেও আমার ধুবুরী অঞ্চলের প্রায় 10খনমান স্কুলের শিক্ষক সকল উপস্থিত আছে। তেওঁলোক সকলকে মহাবিদ্যালয়ের তরফৰ পৰা আমি আদরণি জনাই। আমি অত্যন্ত কৃতজ্ঞ যে আজি যিটো আজি অনুষ্ঠান আয়োজিত করেছে এনভায়রনমেন্ট এন্ড ক্লাইমেট সেল, এই সেলটো স্পন্সরিং এজেন্সি হল আসাম সায়েন্স এন্ড টেকনোলজি মানে এসটেক। গতিকে আমি তেওঁলোকক এসটেকক আমি আজি ওয়েলকামের জড়িয়ে ধন্যবাদ জানাব বিচার আমার এই এনভায়রনমেন্ট এন্ড ক্লাইমেট সেলটো স্পন্সর করার পরে। আমি সকলে জানো যে ওয়াইল্ড লাইফ বা বন্যপ্রাণী আমার কারণে কিমান প্রয়োজনীয়, একদম গোটেই প্রাণী জগতের ভারসাম্য রক্ষার বাবে আমার ওয়াইল্ড লাইফ আমার কিমান প্রয়োজন আমি বহুতে জানো বহুতে নাজানো হয়তো। গতিকে আজি আমি ডক্টর বর্মনের পৰা আমি এইখিনি কথা গম পাম। আপনাদের সকলে নিশ্চয় জানে যে তেখেতে হাড়গিলার উপর গবেষণা করে কনজারভেশনের উপর গবেষণা করে তেখেতে গ্রিন অস্কারও বটা লাভ করেছিল। গতিকে আমি আশা করছি যে তেখেতর যে মহামূল্যবান পরামর্শ যিনি আলোচনা আজি ইয়াত হব সেইখিনি আমার সকলে আমি সকলে উপকৃত হম। আর তেখেতর আদর্শে আমার যিনি
Wildlife biology category as a winner will grace this occasion as a resource person. So I would like to invite Dr. Samuel Say, coordinator environment and climate cell, to introduce resource person with us. So Dr. Say, over to you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Madam, thank you, Madam Dr. Sushmita, for giving me the opportunity to introduce today's resource person. Indeed, today's resource person does not require any introduction, as she is not only known regionally but nationally and internationally too. Still, as a part of the program, I am going to introduce our resource person. She is Dr. Purnima Devi Barman, popularly known as Hargila Vaidev. Dr. Purnima has completed her PhD under Guwahati University on foraging ecology, breeding success and genetic status of endangered greater adjutant stock in Kamrup district, Assam. She is a renowned conservation biologist from our state, associated with the NGO Aranya. She has been awarded with the prestigious Whitney Award, which is also known as Green Oscar Award 2017 by Her Royal Highness Princess Annie in London at Royal Geographical Society on 18th May 2017 for her crusading conservation movement to protect the highly endangered bird greater adjutant stock Hargila. She has also been conferred with the highest civilian award for Indian woman, Nari Shakti Puraskar 2017, by Honorable President of India Ram Nath Kovind, for her tireless work with the community for conservation of Hargila. She has also been conferred with several other distinguished awards, namely the UNDP India Biodiversity Award 2016 from United Nations, the Royal Bank of Scotland RBS Art Hero Award 2016, Green Guru Award 2016, Yamin Hazarika Award, Memorial Award, etc. She is the founder of a group called Hargila Army, Voice of Rural Women as Protector of Tree, to implement Hargila conservation. She is also a green teacher, diploma holder carrying board certificate in environment education. Dr. Purnima has represented our country by attending and presenting in many international conferences and trainings abroad, including China, Cambodia, USA, UK, France, Argentina, Mexico, Guyana, Malaysia, Germany, New Zealand, Canada, Thailand, etc. She is a member of Global Women in Nature Network, and under this global network, she is the honorary director of WIN India, and she has hosted an international conference of WIN in January 2019 at Guwahati, where conservationists from 13 different countries have participated. Dr. Purnima is committed to serve for nature till her last breath. Thank you, madam. Welcome to this platform. Dr. Purnima, madam. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Sheikh. So we are really waiting eagerly to know from you, ma'am. This is a time we love for you, ma'am. I request you to please enlighten us with your speech. But before that, I have a humble request to all my respected participants that please go mute. Your microphone should be mute condition. And please don't write anything in the chat box right now. We will take your query after the presentation. So over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, madam, and thank you so much for organizing this and inviting me. And first of all, honorable principal sir, thank you so much for your interest to hear Hargila's story. It really means a lot. It's such an honor for us. And then my friend Samuel said, Dr. Samuel, we were friends from university, and I'm very committed because we are close friends. I'm very committed. Already, I'm very committed to your college, and it was we already discussed many years ago. to have such event in person. And but I think thanks to pandemic also it didn't happen earlier, but we will do it now. And thanks a lot, especially it means a lot because you all are interested to hear our Hagia story. That means a lot. So please allow me some time. I would like to share my screen and deliver a presentation. And I need your help, please. Let me know if it is feasible. And,
yes, you, ma'am.
I think. Would you see my screen?
Yes, it is coming, ma'am.
Okay, then.
So please give the full screen.
I have given the full screen only.
But it is not available.
Madam, you have to reduce the other screen. Minimize the other screen.
Just minimize the other screen. I have already minimized. I have given it in the slideshow mode only. You have not seen it here.
No, it was not. I have
already
helped you.
Hi.
নাই ম্যাম হোয়াইট স্ক্রিন তো আছে ম্যাম আমার যেটা নরমাল যেটা স্ক্রিন এটা আপনি মিনিমাইজ করে দিও
ও আচ্ছা আচ্ছা আমি বুঝে গেছি এক সেকেন্ড মানে
ওকে ম্যাম প্লিজ টেক ইওর টাইম নো প্রবলেম
হাই মুসে গুড ওপেন করা আছে এখানে মোবাইল এক সেকেন্ড আমি আপকো এটা কাম করো স্টপ শেয়ারিং করে আপকো একবার ট্রাই করো স্টপ শেয়ারিং
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ এইটু বলি ওকে ম্যাম প্লিজ আচ্ছা এটা হইছে
নো ম্যাম
এক্সি মই ক্যামেরা অফ করে ট্রাই করি সো কি হবে না হইছে মানে প্রেজেন্ট না করি সো কই এন্টার স্ক্রিন টু দিম সাউন্ড
বাবা প্লিজ হেল্প ম্যাম
ম্যাম
ম্যাম ফাইন
নমস্কার দি পেলাই আমি আকৌ স্টার্ট কৰিম গতিকে মই জাস্ট সো টুডে উই আর গোইং টু শেয়ার ইয়া এট দ্য সেম টাইম প্রিন্সিপাল স্যার টোল্ড দ্যাট দেয়ার আর মেনি স্কুল টিচার্স অলসো এন্ড স্টুডেন্টস অলসো এন্ড আই থিঙ্ক মেনি টিচার্স আর অলসো দেয়ার ফ্রম ইয়োর কলেজ এন্ড ফ্রম আদার কলেজ এন্ড মেনি স্টুডেন্টস সো আই এক্সটেন্ড মাই হার্টিয়েস্ট গ্রিটিংস টু অল অফ দেম এন্ড ওয়েলকাম দেম টু আই নো to allow me my Hagia journey with all of you. So, actually, first of all, I'd like to share a story, a small story which changed the entire thing in my life. 12 years ago, I had a dream. I 12 years ago story, I had a dream and I wanted to be a big academician or a scientist, and my parents had their own dream with me. But everything changed, and until that moment, I didn't know what is conservation. So I was, I was very fascinated about nature. So I joined RNA, and I got the place. I met many people, but till then, I didn't understand that about anything about community conservation and all. Yeah, I met many people, and all were obsessed with mega species only. And when we talk about conservation, then everyone come with rhinos, tigers, whistler, or iconic species. Yes, we must, but we didn't hear about many people miss to address all other issues with the lesser known species. So how can we gore bug, even okay, good to date into our immune species as a black species, never to know even good to date. So that thing always hit me, and then I decided to do my PhD on this bird, Hardia bird, and my ultimate goal was to do only PhD. So with that, this huge cardamom tree was hosting 9 nests and 9 baby birds fell down. You can see some birds here, one bird, it is a baby bird, you can assume it as an adult, but it is a baby bird. And there are some tiny birds, white colored, they also fell down because the person cut down the tree. And the tree was hosting 9 nests. And I was so embarrassed. I was introvert also at that time. I didn't know how to speak much, but I dared to speak to the person, and I told him, "Dada, apni ekbar kya ho rahi hai? Why did you do so? Why you have cut down a tree? You didn't see the bird. The bird was in breeding season. They had babies, So why you did so?" And the situation became worse, and the person was reacting on me, yelling at me, and he was mocking, and his neighbors joined and all surrounded me, teased me, and started tapping at me, and told me that this Hardia bird, this bird is a bad omen. It doesn't need to live. Why should you bother? Why don't you take it to your home? Why should you bother? Why you are giving us for protecting this? You may do your PhD, but what do we get? Something like that. Then the tree owner gets started. Why don't you start joining us as our housemaid and clean the debris, etc. that the birds does every day? So why don't everyone teasing me and mocking me this way? And some when I again started telling them, I was so actually nervous, embarrassed, trembling. Then I told them that let's bring the birds to the zoo. We can save them. Yeah, we can still save them. A few of them, they are alive. Then they started mocking me. This lady will consume the Hardia meat, the meat of the Hardia on the way. So this was an incident when I was on the way coming back my home, and that day actually I was very, something different happened to me. I was very embarrassed, and I thought that what I'm going to do with my PhD. what was today, what I did, I couldn't even motivate a few people. I couldn't tell them why this bird is important, why should we protect the tree. I couldn't even motivate them what is the, you know, utilization of my education, what I'm going to do with my education. So what I'm going to do with my PhD? So we have to bring the birds, bring the wildlife into the hearts and minds of the people before doing our PhD or research. Something, you know, from the inside came and called me like this, and that day actually my mission started. And very late in the early morning, I started my mission, and I again, I landed and on the place. And from that day, my journey started. And since then, I've been working with more than 10,000 families in the village. And as I have mentioned, that I wanted to be a big academician, but now I feel very proud myself if someone introduced me as a community member. So with this story, actually, I'd like to share my journey, and my friend Samuel had already shared this picture. Actually, this picture tells me, or you know, it has a huge connection with me, and I want my intention for sharing this picture is that because there are many students here, and our principals have already mentioned that many school students are also there. So I want to share with you that the very first day, people always call Hargila as bad women, letters or I, Gela Posa Moraho Kai, Ogu Posorai, and people always told them, Hargila was treated disrespected or hated like, and people didn't, when it was in danger or when it needed rescue, people didn't come forward for rescue. So the very first day when I was holding this bird on my lap, I had goosebumps and something, a deep root connection, I realized, and I want my fellow students or my all the youths present here or all the school children to see our wildlife from that point of view. I want all of you to have goosebumps when you see wildlife, any other species, doesn't matter big or small. So I really want all of you, and I really want all of you to come forward and help them because they need, and help them, support them following the proper scientific method and rules and regulation. So we are always there to help you. Many people are like all the college teachers are here, your principals are is there, my friend Samuel is there. So we all are here. I am addressing this to all my dear students. So now let me come back to our graduation story again. In the very first slide here, just a brief summary of our entire work is Hargila is an endangered bird according to IUCN Red List. Many of you are aware about that. And as I have mentioned, that we are obsessed with our iconic mega species, but Hargila is technically more endangered than our rhinos, tigers, and elephants, and they need help. And there are many other species like Hargila who are treated endangered, but they are not attended. They need help. And just imagine their global population. Just realize that their global population is around 1,200 birds, and habitat loss, poaching, poisoning, other major traits. And in 12 years of time, we could increase the nest numbers of this species by 8 times and increase the population by double. And so today I'm going to share with some photographs and all about all the entire journey. So the same thing, the most importantly, I'd like to mention that in Assam we have more than 75% of global population. So everyone is looking at us. We have to come forward. There is no other way. We have to save this bird from extinction. So here is another important information which I would like to share with all of my dear students. Hargila is an aged bird mentioned by Zoological Society of London, and it is an aged bird means evolutionarily distinct and globally endangered. means something between survival and extinction, which means they need our much attention, all the eight species. And as I have mentioned that I wanted to share the information, it is that as many of the students here from the college students or maybe school students, when our school students will grow up, it might be helpful for them. But there is an age program, age species program, right? By you can search it, age grant or age species. They give us grants for the students like you who want to work. They give a very good grant and training in London. And they continuously help and support. So you should try, you should note it down about this age program. And if you don't find it, please contact me. I'm always there. Then so I think there are many students here or many teachers here who are very good artists. You know, everyone, you know, I think we all have different skills. And so arts can be a deep art. Sometimes arts and painting can be a very important, strong tool for conservation. For example, that is why I am presenting this picture to all of you. So you can see that this picture, this painting was from 1819, and this picture depicts that Hadila was found in Kolkata. Means Hadila was, it also means that Hadila was a symbol of municipality of that on that period. So this means Hadila was abundant in other places, but now Hadila is not. The single information of Hadila found in Kolkata. So we have to be very careful, we have to daily come forward, we have to protect our trees, habitats, wetlands. Otherwise, you know, we'll lose Hadila. So this that is why this picture I have added here. And already I have mentioned, but there might be a question from all of you, later part, that why Hadila is important, what is the ecological importance of Hadila. So I want to add here that Hadila is it plays a very significant role in ecosystem, and it plays a very significant role in ecosystem, and there are our cleaner parts like pulsars and all. There are our cleaner parts, you all know about our pulsars. So they plays they also plays important role in regulating our disease control and all. So they are very important for our ecosystem. And this already I have mentioned, and willingness and support of the communities are must. Communities, conservation is very important for these species. And here you can see a picture which tells us another story which I have already mentioned. Here you can see is breeding in the tall tree, in the top of the tree, tall tree, kadam tree, which are very close to human habitation. That is the biggest problem of Hadila, the conservation problem of Hadila. So people just cut down the tree. Once the birds come for breeding, the tree become vulnerable. People treat them or look them through a different way. They treat them as dirty birds or something like that, or many other reasons also related to development, land expansion and all. So that is the biggest problem. When we can talk about other species like rhinos or tigers or other species who gets government protection in national parks or sanctuaries, the conservation is different there. The conservation agenda is different because they already get government protection. But here just you can imagine like how treated they are. Like they you know, only the people support. We need people support, community support to protect them. And that is the biggest problem. And conservationists do not come forward to save such species. So this is one of the biggest problem. And so we did a pre-campaign survey. Why the tree owners cut down the trees? Why they dislike them? Why the problems were going on? And these are some problems that, as I have already mentioned, I don't need to repeat again. But yes, these are the some. But yes, I want to add some point here that in the beginning season, mainly six, mainly March, maybe especially the six of 2 months, 3 months, or 4 months, they fall down and they die. And some of them could be saved if we rescue them and bring them to a rescue facility and hand raise. But many of them die. And since the time when Harila came to this earth, it is very natural. Harila has a huge mortality. More than 45% of the six fall down. They have a low breeding success. And when these birds fall down and die, it becomes like a headache for the people. And because this is a big bird, and they think that the carcass make their campus rotate and all. So it's a huge conflict. I can't tell you that it's a huge conflict actually to work for Harila, and that is why I think people don't come forward to help them. But we need all of your support actually to help them. And so these are the things people always treat them that this is a bird of forest department, why should we bother? And many tree owners demand cash, and we also, most of the important thing that we experienced that villagers were not at all educated about wildlife, and they never knew that greater adjutant is an important bird, or not only greater adjutant about other species. And this is happening in many areas, and I think our students, every student, I think, have lots of, has lots of duties. We always keep asking, what should we do? What type of work we must do? But actually, there is, no one will come and spoon feed you. You have to find your job, you have to find your responsibility. You have many such species, many such works, in many such villages, which are not under, they are not a part of a protected area. We have many villages where we have threatened species and endangered species. You can start a movement, you can help them. So this way, actually, after our survey and all, we decided, we came up with a different PR plan for the species. We integrated a module of tradition and environment education, and designed our program and for different target groups, and also work specially with different stakeholders and with government and police, forest department. And this way we started our work, and very first of all we started motivating our tree owners and making friendship with them. And I think many of you, when you come forward to save a species, you must respect our communities, you must understand their concern, be friendly with them, and you should be very consistent. You can't stop. Once you come to this wildlife conservation work or this area, you can't stop actually. The people who stops is really, and then this will not get the result. We have to work relentlessly. And this way actually we started a relentless awareness campaign. Not a single day, not a single event we missed. We didn't miss any opportunity to create awareness for Harila. And it was since when the journey began, not a single, as I have mentioned, we don't have any Sunday, we don't have any Saturday. We just started and we kept going on and on. And this way actually we started. Actually, this is a side effect of our work. I didn't have any plan to form this group, Harila Army and all. But this was a side effect of our work, and when we started our work, our Harila Army women group formed, and we formed this group. And can you imagine how many women are there now with us? More than 10,000 women as Harila Army. They are rural women, basically they are housewife, and they feel very respected. And yes, we must actually, it is my request to throw, because this webinar is from government also, I request all the policymakers to give much attention to our rural women, rural communities. They know a lot and they can make a big difference. And here actually, earlier our women, they didn't know that they have a platform for voting for conservation, when I myself found that I have a platform for myself, then I realized, you know, realized to start a platform for our rural women. They can make a big difference if they are educated, because they are nurser, they are creator, they are nurser, and most of them are mother. They can influence a lot. They have a very big influencing role in our society. And they can, if we educate them properly, they can remove the superstition from our society. So with all these angles, we formed our Hargila Army. And the most important agenda behind our Hargila Army is to integrate our Hargila board into the tradition and rituals and cultures of our society. And I think in this point of view, in this regard, our women can do it. Women can integrate a species into our tradition. And this way actually our journey started. And you might have a question, are we only working with women, not men? It is not true at all. We are working with more and more men, because one Hargila Army woman means her entire family, her husband, her children, her brother and all, and their duty is to, you know, keep them in robe and, you know, motivate them and all, and we all are together. And this way we have started a people's movement in Assam, and I'm very proud and humbled also that in many areas in the world, our this campaign, our this module have been tried to be replicated, and we are very honored for this, and we will always try to help all of them. And also we want to learn from other projects and implement it in our projects and our work. And so this way actually dear my dear question, why all these foods and all with you know just this annual education program, actually we have to integrate our culture, our daily life with our environment, with our conservation, then only we will be successful. I have a story again. When I started first and I started organizing meetings, most of the time the male members of the household only came to the meeting, and only a few women members came. And when I went there and asked them, they all told me that we like you very much. It doesn't mean that we are disrespecting. We like you very much, but we can't come because this is not our priority. We have to, you know, cook for our. We have so many works, you know. These are not a priority for us. We have to cook for our children, for our husband. So what I did, I started our environment education with cooking. Started organizing cooking competition in every locality, and our women came like ATNs joined, and then we started playing web of like this is the NRL election games. I'm missing actually there many students here, school students or college students or all of you actually, wherever I go, it doesn't matter what age group are they, I always have these traits and you know these balls and with me always, and I start playing web of life because it is so, you know, participatory, and it's a very I think learning and joyful and motivation game. And this way actually I befriended with all of the women, and they started giving their voice. The women who didn't speak much for this environment education games and all, with this environment education program, the women started speaking a lot and became our, you know, what to say, saviors or followers. And we have a program called Community Teaching Communities Program, and this for this program actually our women get so respected, our women feel so respected, because we formed this educator group among them, and they go and motivate the others. And every day actually I believe myself that rather than I always keep going, I form a group and I always keep going with them, but I always request them to go forward and start communicating with others and all. And and this way actually we roped in so many people actually, and people like have a question, how did you how so many people are working with you? This is not the reason, because we made this community as a stakeholders. We formed this community as a stakeholders, and they feel themselves as the saviors or guardian of the sorts, and they keep going and motivating others. And I'm very proud to share, glad to share this, because there are many children here and our students. So you can also start something like this. If you are going to work for any species, maybe reptile or maybe amphibian or anything, or you can do such kind of headdress, mask, and create awareness. So this kind of headdress we do, and with our women we dance, we do festivals, and this gives a instant touch and feel factor for creating awareness, and you all can also do that. And so we have a pride campaign which we keep doing in our villages and in other villages, and this pride campaign is very effective, strong tool for us. And I think nowadays, I'm in discussion with many colleges and all. They keep sharing with me that they have lots of programs in the VAs, like adopting a VAs and all. And many students also, when you go for such work, you can do some pride campaign, and this is really very effective. And I would like to share with you all these ideas later on, and I'll drop my phone number and all later on after my presentation. And this important program is very important for all of us and very close to my heart, and taking this as an opportunity, I request all of you, all the college teachers, principals, and all of you, and the school teachers and all the students, please join us next time. Why don't you join us in our Haridya Babies, our next year? And this is a very important agenda for all of us, and I would like to share a bit about this program with all of your permission. So this is like, we call it a consummate event, Haridyar consummate event. Like the way we do for, exactly we celebrate it like the way we do for our Assamese expecting mothers. So we celebrate this with the same respect and same way. Actually, when we do it, when Haridya start breeding, when they start laying eggs, incubating, at that time the trees become vulnerable. The trees are either being cut down or hit stone, or any disturbance may cause a very negative impact on their breeding success. And that is why we started this program. When I still remember, it's very funny for me also, it's a memory to say this. When I started visiting house to house and inviting our women to the prayer halls for celebrating Haridya Consummate, they laughed a lot, but they liked it. I think communities like when we are innovative and when we integrate the things with their culture, with their tradition. And this event is so participatory, because it is not like for example, if we invite them for a seminar or a big meeting, it might not be very participatory, because they feel isolated most of the time. But this program is their program, so it is they are hosting it, organizing it, and I'm the facilitator. So this kind of thing, this kind of event is so participatory. You can also replicate it sometimes in any of your work if you want. And so this way actually there are many community prayer halls or community halls. We organize events, and our agenda is to integrate the bird into the tradition. We have lots of NAM program and all, so we integrate Haridya into their own tradition ritual event. And this is a community Gita Bhagavad Procession where many people come forward and join and celebrate. There also we collaborated with them and Mars Haria campaign into this program, and this is really very impactful. And everyone can do this in their project, and it should be situation to situation and culture to culture. So you can have your own such kind of program and design your own. And I always keep telling them that we don't need any classroom or big seminar hall for our programs. Wherever we get a chance, we start our Hargila tale or Hargila story or our future plan or anything. So I think I always keep telling it. I think I quote one Baido from Maria Public School who keeps saying that our NASA is our, you know, our, we don't need a classroom, our NASA is our classroom. So this way actually most of the time we go to the paddy fields and we start our classes, and that is really very impactful. And our work is, I'm very honored to mention that our work is not only saving this bird, but also empowering our women and social changes in the villages. And Samuel had already mentioned about our weekly award, Green Oscar, after this weekly award, actually our project got a new dimension, a big boost, and our communities got enough support, and we could establish a weaving center also, and I could design my research also in a different way, which I couldn't do earlier. And most important thing is that weekly award connected me with policymakers. Earlier, I think I couldn't reach them much, but now policymakers themselves come forward for you know, knowing about this word, and this is, I'm very thankful to them. And this you can see, as I have already mentioned you earlier, that Hargila was treated as bad woman, and you can see the transformation now. I feel very proud of sharing this gamusa, and now this gamusa is so famous in all over the world, and people from all over the world, they want this gamusa, and many products our women do. And these are our weaving, this is a picture from our weaving center. Our
Ma'am, you got muted, ma'am. Please unmute Kori Labo. Ma'am, apni mute hoye goise microphone on.
Ito kete ta bisbaro?
Ei, aba apni 5 minute ban. 5 minutes.
Apni ko kyo banai?
Moi kothe goise.
মই কোন পৰা যাম তেতিয়ালে কষ্ট মানে
আমি ব্যাক কৰা মই গৈ আছো আপুনি এটা শো দা ইয়া 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 গামোসা লৈ কি ঘূৰিছো ইয়েস 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 ইয়েস
মানে ফিলিং হৈছে যে কানেকশ্যন লস মানে লো কানেকশ্যন টু মোৰ মাইণ্ড
এক্চুৱেলি মই আই ওয়াজ সো মেসমেরাইজড বাই ইয়োৰ টক দ্যাট আই ইয়েস ম্যাম প্লিজ প্লিজ
Please, if you don't mind, I have a request. Please keep indirectly on the middle because sometimes I have a feeling that I lost the connection.
Actually, I mesmerized with your work.
Thank you so much. So, actually, I was telling you about Weekly Award and taking this as an opportunity. I really want all of our fellow students to apply Weekly Award near future. Please work hard. And if you work hard, I'm sure you will get Weekly Award Green Oscar one day. And I will be very honored and to help all of you. And so, yeah, then I think I was audible in this slide, right? I was audible, right? Last time?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I can move to this bride. So, okay, that's good. Okay. Then, this is our gamosa, and I'm very proud to say this gamosa because earlier I told all of you about that, the situation that you know that Haridia was treated as bad woman or disease carrying face, but now, see, you can see the transformation, and most important thing is that people all over the world, once this gamosa like anything, this gamosa became an instant hit, and people all over the world, they demand, they want it, and many tourists also come and they are crazy for this, you know, attire and all made by our women. And so you can see our women, we from a picture from our weaving center, and our women are very proud to share this. They don't only sell this in a good price at market, but they share their pride, how proud they are to do this. And they are empowered also, and we provided them a fashion technology diploma. We support from district administration, and this made a difference. And their duty is now to weave only Haridia into their attire and all, and do Naam songs in the prayer hall to bring the bird into the culture and all. So, and to keep monitoring other nays and inform us. So, they are really sincerely doing this job, and women are really very powerful in this case, and all of their husbands are also supporting them. And here I would like to mention why I'm sharing this picture, because this is one of our Haridia Ami Samhita. Just taking this as an example, generally what happens nowadays, Azikali Manuhe, Amar Jinda skin, Bua, Bogole Zanu, Ebila Paguri Jai. So people tend to forget, people tend to avoid, and so it is so important, it is success, we should be very proud of our skin, and we encourage them, these young girls also who are from the village, and we encourage them also, and we train them also on this fashion diploma and technology. And so she is getting such a good income, she is so proud and to do this. And this way actually we have encouraged our women to, you know, to keep this skill intact, and they all are doing it, you know, their base, on their base. And this year actually we linked also them with markets, and so we also, I myself hosted many international events, so and on taking this as an opportunity, we always organize some mela or sort of festival for our women where they join, and they have also, you know, just say you know, interaction with the international communities. And this way actually our women got a new boost, got boosted up and all, and this way actually we started this movement on. And yeah, I always want to share this picture because I'm very grateful to our New Zealand High Commission and New Zealand High Commissioner Madam Joanna, Miss Joanna Kemker. She herself, after I got Vicky Award, she herself contacted, from her office contacted me. I met her in Delhi, and after we met, her office contacted me and offered this grant. Under this grant, we offered 80 sewing machines to our women, and then again our project got a new dimension. And yeah, I'm sharing this picture because I want to request all our students, please be very positive when you work for wildlife conservation. Please be very positive always, and please find your mentors. This is so important, finding your mentors, and always try to surround yourself with good people. You know, we have to be very positive, we have to feel very happy all the time, you know, and it's all challenges. And I have mentors all over the world, and I'm really glad to be supported by them. And so these are, they are from IUCN, and I have many other mentors. I couldn't add all of them here, but just as an inspiring picture I wanted to add, because they are wearing our traditional attire also. And with this actually meeting, for example, if I go with my laptop and PowerPoint and keep telling our story to some person or some important people, they might not listen, but our, these textiles give another story, you know, every trade, I think, there is a story. And our these textiles, they could help our, they could help to spread our story to the entire globe, I think. And I'm very happy to share with all of you about this. And in this pandemic time also, we could support our women. They produce more than 11,000 face masks and all, and people want this also from all over the world. But for this, we need many resources and all. But we have tried our best to keep this online and all. And so you can see, these are some products during the pandemic time. Our women came up with all these products and all. I'm very happy to support them and thankful to all my donors and weekly awards and all. So this way actually we did it. And special thanks to New Zealand High Commission and Madam also, because she has supported us with shipping machine and all. And now it is a very recent development. During the time of Wildlife Week, we got a call from Pasu Bakshi organization who supports communities, and now our products are available online in this website. And I think with this our conservation project got a new dimension again. And we are trying our best. Now let me go to another story now, another part of the story. So I already mentioned earlier that many people demanded cash. So here I would like to share one of my concerns. So what we do, we never give direct cash to people in return of the tree. Instead, what we do, we provide scholarships or any in-kind support or scholarship rewards, or even if we give cash in a different way, like an honorarium or and all. But direct cash for protection of dietary, it might hamper or it might spoil the entire thing. It happened to other projects earlier, and because we don't have a long support. Sometimes we have a project, we can support them, but if next year we don't have a projects for direct cash, what we will do? Then people would demand, and what we will do? That's why when it is a, because I'm just sharing with all of you because I'm encouraging you for community conservation. That is why I think it is one of the important points to mention with all of you. So please, so especially for the students and all, so please be very honest and transparent when you work with communities, and always keep telling them about the fact. Because, for example, when we go with this immersion scholarship, we always keep telling them that this is a one-time reward, this might be two-time reward, or this might be three-time, but after that we might not be able. So this way actually we keep telling, I that is why I mentioned this picture with all of you. And we need to immerse lots of environment champions. I think there are many students here, I think from schools, so I think they would love it. And we need many future leaders, and biodiversity conservation or conservation of species is not only about species, it is about nurturing our young minds, nurturing the young minds of our society, and empowering our communities. So we work with lots of children, especially with schools, and we collaborate with the local schools, and we also recognize them as guardians of sorts. And this way we reach many people, and actually even senior, we have also an education program in their craft classes, converted their classes to craft Hardila classes. So this way we reach many students in Assam, not only in the places we are working, but in other places we try to reach. But this is not enough. We want to reach as much as we can, and this is only possible if we get support from all of you, if we are a big team. And that is why I think I'm here to team up with all of you. So we want to reach many, many students, and we have to get many more young champions for our biodiversity conservation near future. So let us do that. And And here I would like to share with you another story. This is from garbage dump from Guwahati, and I also try to do as much as I can to educate our children from the garbage dump who are Red Pillar children. And this picture is very close to my heart, because when I went and started, you know, this art competition or art program with them, you know, they, it was a different feeling for me, and I can't express this now. And these people, actually, they are really, you know, they are happy people. They might not have all the resources we have, but they are really happy people, and I get joy when I meet them, and I interact, I share my, you know, I knowledge with them, you know, with my capacity. And So now again, I would like to share another event, which is the puppetry. And one of my team member, Disana, she is a specialist in puppetry. So I team up with her, Disana, and we also try to do environment education using puppetry as a tool. But not only for Harvina, but other species also. But we are in some events, especially for Harvina, we did it. And we are trying to do as much as we can. And I request all our children, all you know, I think all the college students and all who are there, so you can also enhance your skill. I think you also have your skill. Sometimes we don't need our skill, and those skills get die. So please don't finish your skill. So please enhance your skill. Who knows, you can also do such type of, you know, and work and spread to the globe. So please do it. And here also I would like to share some other story. Like, there is a group called Evan, Artists and Biologists Unite for Nature. They are an artist group from all over the world, from 85 countries, and they themselves offered me 85 paintings for our campaigns, and I'm very grateful to them. And we have now finished, but this picture was taken from the earlier part, from the budding stage of our area National Learning Center. And now we have finished, and we are going to inaugurate it in December. And we have our Harila Learning Center, and I request everyone, all of you, please join our Harila Learning Center. You also can collaborate, you also can contribute with your own ideas. Someone might contribute with a song, or maybe painting, or any idea, any designing. Whatever skill you have, please join us, and it will be a big opportunity for all of us, for us, especially to connect with all of you. And here also I would like to mention about our Women in National Network, who is I'm leading this chapter from India, and this is a global group with many countries. And I myself hosted with the support of WIN. I was supported by WIN to host a symposium where 13 countries, women from 13 countries, participate, and you can see our Harila Army women were also part. More than 70 women from Harila Army also joined with this scientist community, and they got a different dimension again, a different boost again. And when they mixed up, when they feel very empowered to meet all other strong women, actually, this is the reason why I share this picture with all of you. And I have also strong collaboration with the Cornell of Labo Ornithology from Cornell University. They themselves came and offered this opportunity. They came up with a documentary, and signed some scientists from Cornell University, which is a very respected university in the world. So they themselves came and, you know, supported us. Well, they gave us a film, gifted us a film, and also helped us to study the, you know, just this natural history of the bird. And this is a glimpse from our work. I work with them together, and this is a ecology study at the night. And So these are some scientists from Cornell University. We work together, and sometimes if I get an opportunity, I would like to share the film with all of you and maybe in near future. And we also partner with local police. Our communities are very proud. You win our police is our partner, it really helps us. And it's a legal aspect, but in a very positive way. And yeah, it's really helping our cause. I'm very thankful to the Kamrup police and Assam police for their support. And as I have mentioned, we don't miss any opportunity. So this is the debut in Republic Day, and here our women, you can see our women. So we also do some kind of events like this. You can also do in such events, because these are very respectful events, and we give respect. So you can create awareness taking such events as an opportunity. And I'm very proud to share about our Haria Corner and Deputy Commissioner's Office in Kamrup. And so we set up this Haria Corner, and Deputy Commissioner Mr. Kailash Karthik from Kamrup District, he himself offered this opportunity, and we set up this Haria Corner. And he also created lots of awareness. And taking this as an opportunity, I request principal sir and Samuel and all the faculty members, you can also, if you want, you can also have the Haria Corner at your college. I would like to assist whatever I can. And so Haria was also declared as the mascot of road safety by government from the transport department. And nowadays Haria also, I think, became an iconic species in the world of rhino and tigers and other mega species. And for example, Samuel and Principal sir, you all of you are interested to hear a Haria story. I'm so honored. I think Haria is very privileged for that. So I'm very grateful to all of you for this, and it means a lot. And these are some other stories, like we put nets under the listening tree, and the Haria birds fall down, and the baby birds fall down, and we rescue them. And this is, you can see the Haria, we put nets under the listening tree, and then we rescue them and hand raise them. We send it to Assam State Zoo and hand raise them. And this year, actually, we are trying to do as much as we can. And so we also, in the pandemic time, actually, it was a huge problem. And as I have mentioned, that many birds die, and if not attended also, we could, if the rescue is also not done, they die. And sometimes many birds die by their own also, naturally. And this lockdown time, we had to go through some pain. And I think this, our entire story, although the pictures are very colorful and fancy, but we have, this kind of work, actually, our work has different painful story also. And people complained, and many people related this date with coronavirus also. And then we had to make them happy and control the situation. And then we did a burial, event or a burial, burial event for the program for this bird. And our youth volunteered for this. My team member, Deepankar, you can see, and many other youths, they did it. And this way we try to make our people happy. And these are some reports from post-mortem reports from our Haria bird and baby birds, and the results are not good. You can see all these unusual materials that we found in the post-mortem report. And these things I'm sharing because I really want all of you, all our children, all of you to let us come to a solution about the plastics, because we don't have a segregation idea, and these plastics are carried by the birds also, and I think other wildlife, and this is not good at all for our wildlife and for our species. And these are some study, I think I don't need to share. I'm already getting long, like Excel study and all, some results. And some scanning microscopy study with support from with guidance from my guide, Professor D.K. Sharma, who is educating me, because I'm not an expert from this subject. And here I'm almost to the end of my presentation, so maybe a few slides. These are some of my demo platforms. I have paid all demo platforms. One is about 100 feet, one is about 85 feet, and some other sizes. And I climb myself and do the study of breathing behavior of the birds. So that is another package of our work. Like this is a research part. So and for this, I have also got support from Wildlife Conservation Society, from Pactual Cambodia and Conservation Agency Program, and I could access, I got a training to access 28 this platform in Pactual Cambodia. I was staying there and did the study of Hardia birds found in Cambodia. A few birds are found in Cambodia also. And after this only I came to Assam and had my own bamboo platform, my tower for study the birds. And this is, I'm very proud that this is for the first time we did an experiment with Hargila as an assisted breeding platform, and we were successful. We did it in Assam State Zoo also, and through this we had raised 3 birds. And if you have questions later, but I would like to I'll discuss about on this, and I think I will not elaborate much, but yes, we can do such kind of things following the scientific norms and rules and regulations. So I'm very proud to share this picture because this gave another answer to the science. We just experimented because many conservationists are doing such kind of thing. They have many resources in other countries and they are doing it with other species of birds and stocks. So we wanted to do it with Hargila birds and we are successful. So this picture itself is very inspiring and tells a story how they are raised in this artificial breeding platform. And results were very rewarding and people stop cutting down the trees, and most of the important thing is that tree owners and communities develop the ownership feeling for the bird, and nest numbers increased by 8-fold, population became double as I already mentioned, and we started with 28 nests in the village and now we have over 208 nests in the village, and in all Assam we have over 270 nests. And I think this colony is also contributing to the global population, and we are also working in other districts also now in Morigaon, Nagaon, and we want to do more, and I need all of your support, and I offer my sincere thanks to all my donors, especially communities, district administration, forest department, police, Kamrup police, and all my donors with the award, New Zealand High Commission Conservation Leadership Program, and Colonel Eva Bonitozzi, who is my collaborator for this film and all, and A.C. Tyler, who has supported us for our Hargila Learning Center, and women in NASA network, and everyone, especially all of you, who, you know, for your interest to hear our Hargila story, and together I think we all can fly together and create a big difference. And I, taking this as an opportunity, I also request everyone, please, whenever you have any sighting of Hargila bird in your locality, Hargila is not found in the Thubri area now, but if you see any bird or if you see Lhasa adjutant, which we call as Bortola, please keep informing us. And so with my sincere thanks and for your kind listening, let me finish my presentation and stop sharing my screen, and I would like to move to all of you for any questions and all the feedback. Yeah, so I would like to stop sharing my screen. Yeah, so could I stop sharing my screen? Or are you still there?
No, ma'am. Just please stop sharing.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Fine.
I'm sorry for being long.
No, ma'am.
I'm very tired.
I'm ready to hear another 1 hour from you. It is really a mesmerizing experience for me. And I request my dear participants, if you have any query, then you can please write in the chat box and we will take your questions. But with your permission from Principal Sir, I just want to add one thing. that I think Dr. Barman also agree with me that any environmental renaissance happened when women attached themselves. Whether it is Chipko movement or whether it is the Hargila movement, and it is true today. And Dr. Poonima, it is really nice how this wildlife conservation is related to the community work, how this help the community women to make themselves sustain, and it is really wonderful. মোৰ নিজৰ এটা লাগিছে যে আপুনি ইমান ওচৰতে আছে, কিন্তু আপোনাৰ আমি ইমান দিন আপোনাৰ লগত আমি ইণ্টাৰেকশ্যন কৰা নাই. সো থেংক ইউ ভেৰি মাচ স্যামুয়েল, ইট ইজ ইউ
পাছ. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. আমি এটা লগত সো আমি একেলগে নিশ্চয় কৰিব পাৰিম. আৰু আপোনাৰ কালি স্যামুয়েলে মোক কৈছে, কালি ফোন কৰি পেলাই কৈছে যে তেওঁ কাটি কিবা এটা কৰিব বিচাৰে. সো বহুত ভাল লাগিছে.
Under your guidance in our college, and so it will be definitely there within the next 6 months.
Okay, thank you.
And please be assured that actually a new construction is going on for the geology department here in Botany.
Okay.
And there will be a Hargila corner in the department. For the time being, if possible, then we will start in the old building itself. And another point, madam. If you can suggest some books for our students so that they can know more about Hargila,
yeah,
then we will procure those books in the college library also, and there will be Hargila corner in the college library itself.
In terms of resources,
so they will be there within the next few months, and hope we will be able to collaborate with you more. And there are many other things that we can collaborate. So let us hope for the best. And since Samuel is there in between BN College and you, so hopefully since the bond is very strong, so hopefully it will be a stronger bond in the days to come. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, about the books information, I will take to share Samuel about all the books information. I think it is very to get this for our students. And but now I want to take this as an opportunity. Very first, I want to request all of you. I think you have the bird watching guidebook with in your library. But if you in case you don't have, please. Please, first of all, please have a bird watching guidebook. I think it is not in my table now, but I could show you the book by Vineet. Very very important, I think. And we must encourage our all the students, and especially all the school children and all the students on bird watching, because bird watching is such a tool. We must know all our birds diversity, and it is very important. And once we encourage all of them about birds, it is a saying, whenever we go for any conservation workshop and all, everyone, even it might be a tiger conservation workshop or all, everyone acknowledges, because every conservationist, whether it might be a tiger conservationist or rhino conservationist or any conservationist, they come with bird watching first, you know. Just bird watching is such a tool, and I really encourage our students. And I would like to send some photocopy of the book to Samuel. Yeah, I'll send it to you. To maybe tomorrow I'll send it to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. And another very important thing that I realized from your work, that you have done such a hard work, iman kosto.
খুলি থৈ দিয়া আছে বা নেক্সট ইয়াৰ আকৌ মই এটা বেলেগ ষ্টাডি আছে আৰু যদি যদি চব ঠিক হয় হয়তো এইটো এইটো বছৰ চাগে নহয় নেক্সট ইয়াৰ আকৌ মোৰ পৰা হ'ব আৰু কিন্তু এই বছৰটো মোৰ মাছানোৰ এটা বিয়া হৈছে আৰু
why not few bark conservation forests are established in our country?
Can I directly contact Indigo team? I want you to explain this question.
Okay. আৰু ফৰেষ্ট মোৰ বাৰটো ফৰেষ্টতে আছে কাজিৰঙাত আমি আচলতে কাজিৰঙাৰ ৰাইন আৰু টাইগাৰৰ কাৰণে আমি বিখ্যাত বুলি ভাবোঁ কিন্তু মাৰ্চ আছে Yes, ma'am, right. Because if we say that we human beings are the best creator of God, then it is our duty to do conservation as far as possible, I feel. So we are almost at the end of this program, and may I now request Ms. Mithali Koshpal, Assistant Professor in Geology, PN College, to please offer the formal vote of thanks. So over to you, ma'am.
Sushmita, am I audible, Sushmita?
Yes, ma'am. Please carry on.
Thank you, Dr. Sushmita Sengupta, for giving me the opportunity to deliver the vote of thanks on behalf of the Environment and Climate State of our college. I extend my sincere thanks to our principal, sir, for allowing the sale to organize the webinar and protect the platform. Thank you. Next, I would like to convey my heartiest gratitude to Madam Dr. Purnima Devi Barman for her kind consent to act as a resource person and also for her resourceful deliberation in the program to make it a successful one. Thank you, Madam. I convey my sincere thanks to all the heads and teachers of various schools of Dhurki Town for their kind cooperation and presence in the webinar. My sincere thanks goes to all my colleagues for attending the program. My hearty thanks also goes to all the students who are present in the program to make it successful. I extend my gratitude to Estate, DST, Government of Assam for sponsoring the program. Last but surely not the least, I also convey thanks to GTech for providing the technical support to successfully conducting the webinar. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
So thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mitali ma'am. And with permission from Principal sir, I announce that this is the end of this program. But I feel that this is a new initiative, new beginning with BN College, with Dr. Purnima. And I am very hopeful that in the very short days, 2 or 3 days, I will contact you from the IQS BN College. We have lots of things to do. So thank you very much. Thank you, everybody, and good night to all.
Thank you so much.
Madam Purnima, it will be a new journey with BN College.
Thank you.
I'm getting excited. I'm too excited to do lots of things.
Yeah, see you soon. Bye. Thank you.
Bye.